For August to October, the Bureau's long-range forecast shows above average rainfall is likely for large parts of the eastern and central mainland, and increased chances of unusually warm maximum and minimum temperatures across most of Australia. June rainfall was close to average for most of the country and above to very much above average for large parts of Western Australia and parts of the east. June was drier than average for parts of the south, including areas in Victoria, South Australia, and Tasmania that have been drier than usual over recent months. June maximum temperatures were close to average in the southeast and above to very much above average across much of northern, central, and western Australia. June minimum temperatures were below average and colder than expected for parts of the east and north due to a run of still cloudless nights. Minimum temperatures were above average across the southern half of Western Australia and Western South Australia, with some areas recording their warmest June temperatures on record. July to date soil moisture is average to above average for much of the country. However, soil moisture is below average across parts of the south, including Tasmania. August to October rainfall is likely to be above average across large parts of the eastern and central mainland, including most of Queensland, northern New South Wales, and northern parts of South Australia. For most of western, far northern, and far southeastern Australia, rainfall is likely to be within the typical seasonal range. Most sites are likely to have low streamflow during July to September, with some sites across the north and east likely to have near median to high flow. There is an increased chance of unusually warm maximum temperatures for most of Australia, especially across the north and in Tasmania. There is also an increased chance of warmer than usual nights across Australia. Ocean temperatures in the eastern tropical Pacific are likely to gradually cool over the coming months, but remain warmer than average closer to Australia. Both the Indian Ocean Dipole and the El Niño Southern Oscillation are currently neutral. While a La Niña watch remains active, it doesn't guarantee a La Niña development. For more information, visit bomb.gov.au/climate.